let me on behalf of the management and staff of the Ministry of Information welcome you to the ministry. The permanent secretary would have been here, but for a little assignment out of this office. So on his behalf and on behalf of the management staff, I want to welcome you.
Thank you.
I want to also welcome your wonderful team. I know you've been itching to come around to pay a courtesy call, and that goes to show the seriousness that you attach to your duties and also the intentions that you have to collaborate and partner with my ministry to effectively police the entire state, the area of your duties. I just want to commend you for that.
Thank you, sir.
And to say that my ministry has always been disposed to work into the Federal Road Safety Commission in ensuring that the very essence of your commission is actualized in the body state. Understandably, the Federal Road Safety Commission is a federal establishment that is working with states of the Federation to ensure that the very mandates of the commission are achieved. So I want to assure you that we will continue to work with you to ensure that you succeed in your office. For us as a ministry, we understand the importance of the commission in our state. The issue of orientation is part of our core mandates, giving orientation to people, ensuring that they have a sense of discipline or abide the ethos and etiquette of the state, and also going by the core values of the state. And one of them is to obey all regulations, including regulations on the use of roads. Beautify the whole place by putting up wonderful flyovers, and also, of course, street lights and water fountains and all of that. So what is important at this point is for the road users to cooperate, whether they are coming from outside the state or they are living within the state, for them to cooperate. And no any other agency has this particular responsibility of controlling of traffic other than you. Even within the state level, we don't have such as a mandate except you. And so it requires that we will collaborate with you to ensure that we get our various roads policed in such a way and manner that people will be obedient to the very regulations. I want to emphatically mention that with you, we can be sure that accidents will be reduced. There are two ways to a road. If a road is very smooth, it can also cause accident. If a road is not smooth, it can also cause accident. But what is the saving point is where you come in, where your work comes in. And that is ensuring regulations in the way and manner people behave, the road users behave. I want to say that, yes, it is true that you have more or less powers within the federal roads and also partnership that will also police our state roads. I think that you need to look inwards to see how you can work with other agencies within the state to see how you can help us to police not only the federal roads, also the state roads, even the local roads, you know, by using, taking advantage of all of the departments, including the intelligence that you have just mentioned to us, to ensure that you work on our people to really obey the regulations of the road. I want to also mention that the street lights, sorry, the traffic lights that the governor did build for the major junctions, people are beginning to disobey them. Honestly, it does bother me because I think that a man who has done all of these things, we should just show gratitude to God and honor to him by obeying some of these regulations. And so we are beginning to see people who don't obey the traffic lights. And let me tell you here that this your clothes, this your uniform goes with horror. If at any point in time you see just one singular person standing on those major junctions, it will really make a big difference. And we are also having a lot of volunteers, voluntary organizations that are also helping. But with you, you are the institution. You bring the order that will make them to effectively police those junctions.